Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the first BMW Group press conference in 2007. My name is Maximilian Schöber. I head the Corporate Communications and Public Affairs Division. Just a few words about today's press conference. Unfortunately, ladies and gentlemen, Norbert Reithofer, our CEO, is not present today, as he has several flu and the doctor forbid him to fly. He regrets not being able to be here, however, he extends his best wishes to all of us here today. But nevertheless, Michael Ganahl, board member for sales and marketing, will step in for Norbert Reithofer. He will present to you the first product highlights of the year, together with Klaus Dräger, our board member responsible for development and purchasing. Of course, Tom Perfs, head of our US holding corporation, is also with us here today. As is customary, you will receive handouts with today's speeches in several languages at our counters. Afterwards, we invite you to have a closer look at our new vehicles, and you are almost welcome to take pictures at the stand. I would also like to remind you that our two other brands within the BMW Group are here in Detroit. We would be delighted if you would join us at Rolls-Royce at 5:25 p.m. today. And the Mini brand will be presenting its new models at the Mini stand tomorrow at 1:20 p.m. And now, ladies and gentlemen, colleagues, I would like to hand over the mic to Michael Ganahl.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to our stand. And just right at the beginning, firstly, let me wish you all the best for the year 2007. It's a great pleasure for BMW to be here at the 100th anniversary of the Detroit Motor Show. The American market is of particular importance to our company. The United States is the largest individual market in the world for the BMW Group. Detroit has long been a motor show at which we present our retail figures for the past financial year. So today, we want to continue the tradition once again. In 2006, the BMW Group raised retail by 3.5%, totaling to 1.37 million vehicles. It was our goal to achieve a new retail high in 2006, and we clearly have met this goal, while at the same time remaining the world's leading premium manufacturer. Just a few words about the three brands. The BMW brand grew by 5.2% to a total of 1.19 million vehicles in 2006. As expected, the Mini brand declined by 6.2% to 188,000 vehicles last year due to expansion measures at our British plant in Oxford. And Rolls-Royce delivered 805 Phantoms to customers, the fourth consecutive increase since the launch of this model in 2003. With these excellent results, all three brands, BMW, Mini, and Rolls-Royce, were leaders in their respective segments. And not to forget, for the first time, retail of our motorcycle business exceeded the magic mark of 100,000 units, outperforming last year's result by 2.7%. Based on last year's business performance, our pre-tax target of 4 billion euros for the financial year 2006 remains unchanged. As in the past, we will announce our figures for revenue and earnings this coming March. Although we are pleased with these achievements, we have no intention to rest on our laurels. In fact, we intend to grow further in the business year 2007 in order to continue our success story. This will mean a new sales record for each of our brands, BMW, Mini, and Rolls-Royce. Originally, we had set ourselves a retail goal of 1.4 million units for 2008. Now we are going to go one step further. We plan to deliver more than 1.4 million vehicles to customers worldwide in 2007. Gentlemen, this is how we at the BMW Group see clean energy in the future. This vehicle follows our comprehensive, efficient dynamic strategy. In the long run, hydrogen as a source of energy is a possible solution for sustainable individual mobility. We have been very pleased with the positive feedback this vehicle has received, especially here in the US. The Hydrogen 7, which is based on a BMW 760i, is one of the most innovative cars in the world and a vision for the automotive future. The BMW 7 Series is truly unique since it can be powered by both gasoline and liquid hydrogen. This Hydrogen 7 is proof of our innovative power. It also shows how the BMW Group helps protect the environment and how seriously we take corporate social responsibility. We also realize that many more steps need to be taken before this technology will be available for mass use, from the infrastructure to the environmentally friendly production of hydrogen. But we are proud to have taken the first step and to demonstrate what is possible. We are working on a three-tier strategy under the heading of efficient dynamics. Our long-term focus is on using zero-emission hydrogen in combustion engines. First, let's welcome the new BMW X5. Gentlemen, I guess I do not have to introduce this gentleman to you, Tom Purvis, the head of BMW North America.
Hello, Michael.
Tom.
Thank you.
Tom, you are in a fortunate position. Not only the fact that this car is built in Spartanburg in US, you already started delivery of this car to customers since end of November, so you must have some experiences. Tell us about your results?
Well, I mean, it's been really very well received since we launched the new X5, but I have to say that we'd expect nothing less because it builds on such a successful predecessor. I mean, when we introduced the first X5 back in 99, built in Spartanburg and exported to the world, we really established the sports activity vehicle segment. It's been hugely successful. Over that period of time, we sold 600,000 vehicles, and the life cycle is phenomenal. I don't think there's been a single vehicle that's done more to conquest new customers for us here in the United States than the X5. And of course, the United States has become a very important market for BMW, and we're now number one European premium luxury car manufacturer. And we're proud of that. But of course, with the new X5, we answered the questions customers had asked about the previous one. Could we have a little more space, more interior space, the opportunity to put two additional jump seats in the back, a little more luxurious interior? Yes, of course, even larger and better cup holders. But actually, it's the integrity in the engineering in the car that's so important, because the body of the vehicle alone is 15% stiffer. It's the first BMW with double wishbone front suspension, makes it more agile, much more fun to drive, but with terrific ride quality at the same time. It has our Valvetronic engines, more fuel efficient, better performance, unique Valvetronic technology to BMW.
And yet, at any other motor show. So let's welcome the new BMW 3 Series convertible. Gentlemen, may I introduce to you Klaus Träger, my colleague, member of the Board of Management in charge for development and purchasing. I guess he's the right person to tell us more about the characteristic of this beautiful car.
Michael, thank you very much for the introduction. Ladies and gentlemen, BMW has 70 years of experience in producing convertibles. And all this experience and also our innovative ideas are reflected in this new BMW 3 Series convertible. I would like just to point out three highlights with this BMW 3 Series convertible. Number one, we do have now a retractable hardtop. It is a lightweight steel retractable hardtop, and this lightweight steel retractable hardtop makes everyday use for the vehicle more convenient. It makes the car feel more solid and more practical. And we were even able, with this retractable hardtop, to maintain those beautiful design lines which are so characteristic for a BMW convertible. The second point I want to highlight is, beside our suspension and our chassis, we do have new inline six-cylinder petrol engines. And these inline six are equipped with high precision injection. This high precision injection will give us more mileage and, on the other side as well, more power, which in the end underlines the BMW typical values of ultimate driving machine. And the third and last point, I think this car has some beautiful interior detailed solutions which are really clever solution, and these go with a beautiful and much more luxurious interior. Michael, I think these are the main points I would like to highlight, and I hand over to you again.
Thomas, thank you a lot. The rest of the story is told us by our eyes.